गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी केमिकली करेक्ट एयर फ्यूल रेशियो और दैट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज थियोरेटिकली रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ एयर. सो वी विल फर्स्ट बिगिन विद लिक्विड फ्यूल दैट इज पेट्रोल. इट इज कॉल्ड एज ऑक्टेन एंड द केमिकली करेक्ट एयर फ्यूल रेशियो इट इज सेड एज स्टोइकोमेट्रिक एयर फ्यूल रेशियो. Stoichiometric air fuel ratio, or it is also called as chemically correct air fuel ratio. So first we will see how much air is required if we are taking a liquid fuel that is a petrol, and its chemical formula is C8H18. This is for octane. The purest fuel in gasoline. No doubt there is a number of grades, just like a coal also having a grades. Similarly, liquid fuel petrol having a grades. So highest purest form is octane, and its chemical formula is C8H18. Now we will see how this petrol required air to get completely burned. Completely combustion. So basically, we take fuel plus air. When this fuel and air get burned, then we obtain exhaust gases. That is called product of combustion. Product of combustion. Because that exhaust gases might have CO2, water vapors. If there is a deficiency of air, that means sufficient amount of oxygen is not supplied, then some part is get converted into carbon monoxide. If sulfur is there, then it is SO2 gases. So all these gases after burning, that is called the product of combustion. But here we are taking only the theoretical, so we are going to examine all this concept on the basis of only if it is completely burned, completely converted. So fuel, as I said, we are taking the fuel as a octane, liquid fuel, gasoline. So fuel is C8H18 plus air. Now the air, we have a two concept on volume basis and second is mass basis. In any air, we assume that there is a fixed proportion of oxygen and nitrogen, and we neglect other content of the air. Other content, it may have some inert gases, argon, krypton, water vapors. So we assume only by volume, we assume 21% oxygen plus 79% nitrogen. Other content we assume negligible. On mass basis, we assume 23% oxygen and 77% nitrogen. Correct. So there is a volumetric analysis of this on the basis of mass. If we are taking volume basis, then we can say that 21% oxygen plus 79% nitrogen is equals to 100% air. Now, suppose I divided this by 21 very huge. So it become 1 O2, that is oxygen, it will be 3.76 N2. So whenever I am talking about air on the basis of volume, during combustion if I require 1 O2 oxygen, so by default with this 1 oxygen I have to supply 3.76 N2, because for combustion we are taking atmospheric air. So by default 3.76 N2 will be there along with your oxygen, and N2 behave like a inert gas. It is not taking a part in a combustion chemical reaction, so it remains as it is. But we can't separate this N2 from air. So whenever we supplied oxygen for combustion of fuel, so along with 1 oxygen, 3.76 N2 will be there. So what is the total volume in that case? So it becomes 4.76 air. That means for 1 oxygen we have to supply total 4.76 air, because air having mainly two components, oxygen and nitrogen, other are nothing. So hereafter always remember, whenever we are supplying oxygen, that oxygen will not be alone, it will be along with the nitrogen. If it is a volume based, then for 1 oxygen we have to supply 4.76 air. Now what about a mass basis? Now in mass basis we know that 23 is oxygen, 23% of oxygen plus 77% of nitrogen, so it will give 100% air. Same way, if I divide 23 on both sides, so it become 1 O2 plus 3.45 N2 is equal. That means 1 kg of oxygen is always come with 3.45 kg of nitrogen. And the addition of this is nothing but 4.45 air. So on the mass basis, if I want to supply 1 kg of oxygen, then I have to supply 4.45 kg of air. On volume basis, if I want to supply 1 O2, then I have to supply 4.76 volume of air. So there are two units for combustion. So either we are taking volume basis or mass basis. So it depends on the that situation, that numerical values. What it is asked, it is asked on volume basis, then we have to use this. If it is on mass basis, then we have to supply air on this basis. Hopefully it is clear. Now come back to our main problem. So we are taking liquid fuel, gasoline, octane and air, because we don't have a separate oxygen cylinder, we are supplying air itself for oxygen. So fuel plus air, it gives the product of combustion, all the exhaust gas content. It might be have water vapors, CO2, CO, sulfur dioxide and other. So our octane fuel C8H18, air. Now we are taking on the basis of volume. So air will be O2 plus 3.76 N2. And after burning, so hopefully this is clear, so I am going to clear this. Now after burning, what we get? Carbon. carbon get converted completely into CO2, CO2. Plus we get this hydrogen converted into H2O. Plus whatever be the N2 is there, it will not take place in any chemical reaction and it will remove out as it is, just like the inert gas. So if there is a complete combustion, then we get CO2, water vapors and N2. Other content we are neglecting itself. In air also we are neglecting other content. We are taking only oxygen and nitrogen. On volume basis we get 1 O2 plus 3.76 N2. Now we have to balance this. How much carbon? 8 carbon. So definitely after complete combustion it will be converted into 8 CO2. How much H? 18. So 18 H converted into 9 H2O. So this is H2, so it becomes 18 H. So this 18 H converted into 9 H2O. Now if I am going to balance this oxygen requirement, here oxygen required is 8 O2. For this complete combustion, 8 times O2 is required to get complete combustion of carbon. Here we required 9O. 9O, that means 4.5O. So H2O, so H2 is 9, so O is 9. So in terms of O2, it is 4.5O2. So total combustion required 8 O2 for carbon and 4.5 O2 for hydrogen. So if I add this, so it will give 12.5 oxygen is required. So oxygen O2 is 12.5 on volume basis, correct? So here only 1 O2 is there, and 1 O2 come along with 3.76 N2. And our requirement is 12.5 oxygen, so multiply 12.5. Now 12.5 O2 plus 12.5 into 3.76 N2. This much N2 remains as it is in combustion product. So 12.5 multiply by 3.76. And so this is for balancing, and we know that this whole thing is nothing but a product of combustion. So we can write this C8H18 plus 12.5. Now this is 1 oxygen, 3.76 N2. On volume basis it is 4.76 air, and this is given product of combustion. Now what is the air fuel ratio? That means how much fuel is actually required amount of air to get completely burned. So we will find out mass of fuel. So mass of fuel, what is the fuel? C8H18. So 8 carbon plus 9 H2. C8H18, so 8 carbon plus 9 H2. What is the carbon? So it is 12 for hydrogen, it is 2 molecular weight. So carbon having a molecular weight 12 kg per kmol, hydrogen having a 2 kg per kmol. So number of moles of carbon is 8, number of moles of hydrogen is 9. So molecular weight, so it is given 114 kg. So mass of air, 114 kg. Now mass of air, multiplied by 4.76. This is number of moles of air, and air molecular weight, it is 29 kg per kmol. So this is molecular weight of air. This is the total number of moles of air. So it is 1725.5 kg. That means for 114 kg of fuel, how much air is required? 1725.5 kg of air is required. And this air is for complete combustion. So all carbon get converted into CO2, complete combustion. All H2 converted into water vapors, H2O. That means this much amount of air is required for this much amount of fuel. Now, what is the stoichiometric air fuel ratio or chemically correct air fuel ratio? So, it is mass of air divided by mass of fuel. Mass of air 1725.5 divided by 114. So it comes 15.14. So it is round up to 15. So for octane fuel, what is the stoichiometric air fuel ratio or chemically correct air fuel ratio? It is 15. 15, that is because divided by 1. So 15 is to 1. So 1 part of fuel require 15 parts of air. This is the stoichiometric air fuel ratio. Now imagine, for 1 kg of fuel, we required about 15 kg of air, correct? For complete combustion. For 1 kg of fuel, if I am supplying 10 kg of air, what happened? So if I am supplying lesser than this stoichiometric air fuel ratio, this is theoretically air, theoretically it required 15 for 1 kg of fuel. If I am supplying air lesser than this, so definitely all carbon will not convert into CO2. Some carbon will convert in CO, carbon monoxide. Why? Because there is a deficiency of oxygen. Why deficiency of oxygen? Because we are supplying less amount of air. If we are supplying less amount of air, so oxygen content will be less. So some carbon will get converted into CO2 and some carbon partially converted and it forms CO. So if the product of combustion having a term CO, very important question many times asked in your oral exam, if product of combustion having a term of CO, then what is the quality of that air fuel mixture? Quality of air fuel mixture means where there is a deficiency of air, or there is an excess of air, or it is exactly chemically requirement, whatever be the requirement, accordingly you are supplying air. So if there is a CO, carbon monoxide, in your product of combustion, so definitely there is a deficiency of oxygen. That means we are supplying lesser than your stoichiometric air fuel ratio or theoretically air. If in your product of combustion along with CO2, H2O and N2, if there is O2, oxygen is there, that means we are supplying more than stoichiometric air fuel ratio. Suppose 1 kg fuel required 15 kg air, but I am supplying 20 kg air. So out of 20, 15 will be used for complete combustion and 5 remain as it is and it will come along with your exhaust gas. So if product of combustion having O2 oxygen, that means we are supplying excess air, excess than is required. If your product of combustion having CO, that means we are supplying lesser amount of air. So there are 3 kind of mixtures. Chemically correct mixture, that is called stoichiometric air fuel mixture. If air is more, so fuel 1 but air is more, that mixture become lean, diluted. In general language we can say that mixture become diluted because fuel is less but air amount is more, so your mixture become diluted, that is called lean mixture, where excess amount of air is there. But if air amount is lesser, then that mixture become concentrated. So fuel air mixture become concentrated, that is called rich mixture. So there are 3 kind of mixtures. Either mixture is stoichiometric, which is as per the chemical requirement, or it is a lean mixture where amount of air is more, or it is a rich mixture where amount of air is less. So this is for liquid fuel, octane. Now we will come back to our main topic, that is coal. When we are talking about coal, so this stoichiometric air fuel ratio, or that is theoretical air, so stoichiometric word is not used, it is called theoretical air. How much, as per the chemical composition, how much the air is required, that is called theoretical air. If I am supplying more air than this, then there will be definitely oxygen will remain in product of combustion. If I am supplying lesser than this, so there will be CO, carbon monoxide will be there. Now in coal, any coal, the mainly it having carbon, so coal composition, it mainly having carbon, then hydrogen, then sulfur, and itself it having some inherent oxygen. So in coal itself there is oxygen, but this oxygen is not taking place directly in any chemical changes unless you burn that coal. When we burn that coal, that time whatever is the oxygen content in the coal, it also taking a part in combustion. So imagine, suppose your coal required 4 kg of oxygen, and itself in your coal there is 1 kg oxygen itself inherently inside the coal. So from outside we require only 3 kg of oxygen, because 1 kg itself from coal it will taking part during the combustion. So let's see how the coal is having this content, and for this content, for complete combustion, how much amount of air is required. So we will start with carbon. So for complete combustion of carbon, ऑक्सीजन. तो कार्बन प्लस ऑक्सीजन इट गिव्स कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड CO2. नाउ ऑन मोलर बेसिस, ऑन मास बेसिस, हाउ मच इज द मॉलिक्यूलर वेट ऑफ कार्बन? इट इज 12. ऑक्सीजन इट इज O2, सो दैट मींस 2 टाइम्स O. And 2 times O, so molecular weight of O is 16. Molecular weight of O2 is 32, but molecular weight of O is 16. Again here, molecular weight of carbon is 12 plus molecular weight of O2, that is 2 times 16. So it is 12 kg plus 32 kg oxygen. It gives 12 plus 32, 44 kg of CO2. It means if your coal having a 12 kg of carbon, to burn it completely, we require 32 kg of oxygen. Then only we get as a product of 44 kg of CO2. Now per unit. So for per unit, I am dividing both side by 12. So it become one carbon required 8 by 3 oxygen. And it will convert 11 by 3 CO2. So one carbon, now forget about the product of combustion. Now we are just considering this part. One carbon required 8.3 times oxygen. If I double the carbon, if there is 2 carbon, so it will be 8 by 3 multiplied by 2 times. So 1 carbon required 8 by 3 times of oxygen. So whenever I am talking about a carbon in coal, so whatever is the content of carbon, I require oxygen by 8 by 3rd times of that content of carbon. So 1 carbon required 8 by 3 oxygen. If 2 carbon, so it required 2 multiplied by 8 by 3 oxygen. If it 10 carbon, so it required 10 multiplied by 8 by 3 oxygen. It means for complete combustion of carbon, what is the requirement of oxygen? Oxygen required 8 by 3 times of carbon. So if 1 carbon is there, so 8 by 3 oxygen is required. 2 carbon is there, so multiply by 2. So 2 multiply by 8 by 3. 10 carbon, so 10 multiply by 8 by 3. So oxygen requirement for complete combustion of carbon is 8 by 3 times of whatever be the carbon content. So for complete combustion of carbon, we require 8 by 3 times of carbon, this much amount of oxygen. Now second, that is hydrogen. Hydrogen H2 plus O2, it is going to convert when completely burned, so it becomes H2O. For balancing this, 2 times H2 plus O2, it gives 2 times H2O. Now, molecular weight 2 multiplied by H2. What is the molecular weight of H2? So it is 2. For H, it is 1. For H2 it is 2 plus for this O2, that means 2 multiplied by O, that is 16. It is gives 2H2, that is 2 plus O, that is 16. So it become 4 32. It gives twice 18. So 4 plus 32, it gives 36. Now again, 4 hydrogen required 32 oxygen. I am getting 36 H2O. For unit, we will divide both sides by 4. So it is 1 hydrogen required 8 oxygen and it will give 9 H2O. In other word, for complete combustion of 1 hydrogen, we require 8 oxygen. So, complete combustion. Oxygen required is 8 times of hydrogen. So if I am making it 2 hydrogen, so it required twice 8. 3 hydrogen, twice 8. So oxygen requirement is for complete combustion of hydrogen is 8 times of hydrogen. So if 20 hydrogen is there, so 8 times of 20. That much oxygen is required. Now the last, sulfur. So sulfur, complete combustion, we are talking about complete combustion only. Sulfur plus oxygen, so it gives sulfur dioxide, SO2. Sulfur having a molecular weight 32, oxygen 2 into 60. So 32 plus 2 into 16. So here 32 sulfur, again 32 oxygen, it gives 32, 64 SO2. That is 32 sulfur required 32 oxygen and it gives 64 SO2. For unit, so divided by 32 on both sides. So 1 sulfur required 1 oxygen and it gives 2 SO2. So complete combustion. Sulfur, oxygen requirement is 1 ton. So if I am taking 2 sulfur, so oxygen will require 2. If require 10 sulfur, so oxygen will be 10. So 1 time of sulfur, that much amount of oxygen is required if we are considering complete combustion of. Now, we get oxygen requirement 8 by 3 for carbon. So, whatever be the carbon content is there, if anyone asking you for 12 kg carbon, how much oxygen is required? So, multiply by this, carbon is replaced by 12. So, 8 by 3 multiplied by 12, this much amount of oxygen is required. So, 8 by 3 of carbon. Oxygen required for hydrogen, 8 times hydrogen. So if there is a 15 hydrogen, so 8 times hydrogen, that means 8 into 15, this much oxygen is required. For sulfur, one dimes of sulfur, so 32 sulfur, so it requires 32 oxygen. Correct? So, carbon get completely burned, form CO2, hydrogen completely burned, form water vapors, H2O, sulfur completely burned, form SO2. And during this all complete combustion, we require oxygen. And oxygen, we have two sources. Either itself, your coal having oxygen content during burning, this oxygen will take place in a reaction, playing a role and utilized during combustion. Also, we are supplying air, and that air having oxygen content, and that air also along with this oxygen taking place get completely burned. Now we will consider air now. Hopefully this is understood, what is the chemical reactions and what much amount of oxygen is required. Now we are talking about air. So till now we come to know that for carbon, hydrogen and sulfur, amount of oxygen required is 8 by 3, 8 H and 1 time of sulfur. Now for air, on mass basis, we assume that 23% of oxygen is there and 77% of nitrogen is there, and this is become 100% of air. Remaining other content of air we assume negligible, so we neglect. We are only assuming O2 and N. So 23 kg of oxygen come along with 77 kg of N2, and this become total 100 kg of air. So 23 kg oxygen is there inside the 100 kg of air. That means if I require 23 kg of oxygen for complete combustion, so I have to supply 100 kg of air. For 1 kg of oxygen, so divided by 23, so it becomes 1 kg of oxygen come along with 3.45 kg of nitrogen, and if you 1 plus 3.45, that means 4.45 air. So if my requirement is 1 kg of oxygen, I have to supply 4.45 kg of air, because by default oxygen will come along with nitrogen. And on mass basis we come to know that 1 kg of oxygen come along with 3.45 kg of nitrogen. So whenever we require oxygen for combustion, we are not separately sending this oxygen, we are supplying air, and air has been by default nitrogen content. So for 1 kg of oxygen we have to supply 4.45 kg of air. Now for our coal, for carbon it is required oxygen 8 by 3 carbon. This much oxygen is required for complete combustion of carbon. 8H, this much oxygen is required for complete combustion of hydrogen. And 1S, this much oxygen is required for complete combustion of sulfur. Now, the coal having this content, carbon, hydrogen, sulfur, oxygen, What is the actual theoretical air required? So theoretical air is calculated as carbon 8 by 3 times carbon for hydrogen, 8 times hydrogen plus sulfur, so it is 1. This much oxygen is required if your coal having carbon, hydrogen and sulfur, but oxygen will not come alone, it will come along with this N2. So we have to supply this much amount of air. So multiply by 4.45. This much amount of air we have to supply for complete combustion of this coal. So theoretical air requirement of complete combustion of coal having carbon, hydrogen, sulfur content this much. But what about this coal? As I said, oxygen inherently having that coal, it also take part during combustion. If there is no oxygen in coal, then exact this much amount of air we have to supply to fulfill the requirement of oxygen. But already there is oxygen, this oxygen also taking part during combustion. So the actual outside air oxygen requirement is reduced. Minus oxygen, but this oxygen is belongs to coal itself. So in suffix, oxygen, coal, that means whatever be the content of oxygen inside the coal, that oxygen we have to minus, and remaining oxygen we have to supply through. So this is the complete equation to calculate theoretical air for combustion of coal. So 4.45 in bracket, what is the oxygen requirement? 8 by 3 times carbon plus 8 times hydrogen plus S times sulfur minus oxygen content in the coal. So in numerical might be possible if they given that your coal sample having 32% of carbon, 12% of hydrogen, suppose 45% of sulfur and 13% of oxygen. So we have to replace this H carbon as sulfur oxygen here and multiply by 4.45. So this much theoretical air is required for complete combustion. Now imagine if I am supplying lesser than this air, so definitely there will be deficiency of oxygen and your coal will not be completely converted into CO2. Hydrogen will not be completely converted into H2. But during chemical reaction, remember, this is also many times asked in oral exam. We know that if carbon not completely converted into carbon dioxide, then there is a formation of CO. But if you are talking about incomplete combustion, then hydrogen also, there is a possibility hydrogen will not completely convert it into H2O. But during chemical reaction, remember one thing, whatever be the hydrogen is there, oxygen combined first with hydrogen and completely converted into H2O. Remaining oxygen content will utilize for converting carbon. So it never happen that your hydrogen will not be converted into H2O. So whatever be the air supplied, first it form H2O, then remaining oxygen will react with carbon. If there is a deficiency, then there will be a CO2 as well as CO. If there is excess, then along with this there will oxygen in your exhaust gases. So hopefully the theoretical air required for coal, what is excess air, what is deficiency of air, these points are covered here.